evening and happy Friday. Happy Poetry Friday. From a roof overlooking the Colosseum. It's a little rainy today, so not the most spectacular sunset, but it's Caroline Crumpacker's birthday. And so we are going to celebrate with two poems that involve parties. And I can't wait till we can celebrate in person. The first one is by Mark Strand, our dear friend. Mirror. A white room and a party going on, and I was standing with some friends under a large gilt-framed mirror that tilted slightly forward over the fireplace. We were drinking whiskey, and some of us, feeling no pain, were trying to decide what precise shade of yellow the setting sun turned our drinks. I closed my eyes briefly, then looked up into the mirror. A woman in a green dress leaned against the far wall. She seemed distracted. The fingers of one hand fidgeted with her necklace, and she was staring into the mirror, not at me, but past me, into a space that might be filled by someone yet to arrive, who at that moment could be starting the journey which would lead eventually to her. Then, suddenly, my friend said it was time to move on. This was years ago, and though I have forgotten where we went and who we all were, I still recall that moment of looking up and seeing the woman stare past me into a place I could only imagine. And each time it is with a pang, as if just then I were stepping from the depths of the mirror into that white room, breathless and eager, only to discover too late that she is not there. And this is another little party poem by me from my bilingual book called Olfactorium about perfumes. More on that if you want to message me. This is Mon Parfum Chéri par Camille, brazenly stealing lines from Yeats's poem, Adam's Curse. Is Adam's Curse? Yeah. She glides into the room, her velvet skirts drag languid, hem come half undone, awake. There's many a one shall find out all heartache of violet and iris, queer tinctures. The candles flicker, lavender shadows cavort in corners, porphyry to plum. Our host sees her, greets her with a salam, and finding that her voice is sweet and low, and kisses her, guides her to the window. He deftly lights her Gauloise, strokes her palm, her skin not young, but smoothed with years of balm, because to be born woman is to know. She rustles in her bag, pulls out a bottle, that purple wine whose grape is named for tears, a stone-walled garden overgrown for years, and we must labor to be beautiful. Colosseum, sun,
set. Hello.
Damiano.
So, this is already read from this. It's the complete poems, the Italian edition that Moyer and I edited and translated. And this is from Men and Camel, 2006, I think. Specchio. Un salone bianco nel vivo di una festa e io stavo con amici. Sotto un grande specchio dalla cornice dorata, leggermente inclinato in avanti sopra il caminetto. Bevevamo whisky e alcuni di noi, non provando dolore, disquisivano su quale fosse l'esatta sfumatura di giallo che il sole cadente conferiva ai nostri bicchieri. Chiusi gli occhi solo per un poco, poi alzai lo sguardo allo specchio. Una donna, vestita di verde, stava appoggiata alla parete più distante. Pareva assente, le dita di una mano giocavano nervose con la collana e lei guardava fisso nello specchio, non me, ma oltre di me, uno spazio che poteva essere colmato da qualcuno che doveva ancora arrivare, che in quell'istante forse iniziava il viaggio che l'avrebbe condotto da lei. Poi, d'improvviso, gli amici dissero che era ora di muoversi. Sono passati anni e anche se ho scordato dove andammo e chi fossimo, ricordo ancora l'istante in cui alzai lo sguardo e vidi la donna guardare fisso oltre di me, un luogo che potevo solo immaginare, e ogni volta provo una pena acuta, come se in quel momento uscissi dalle profondità dello specchio ed entrassi nel salone bianco, ansimante, ardente, soltanto per scoprire troppo tardi che lei lì non c'è. And from olfactorium, which is a large section of synesthesium, the prize-winning book by poet Moira Egan. Anyway, Mon parfum chéri par Camille. Entra planando nella stanza, la gonna di velluto come languido strascico, orlo semiscucito, una scia, a tanti spezzerà il cuore quella malia, di viola e iris, stravaganti pozioni. Le candele tremolano, onde di lavanda corbettano negli angoli, color porfido e prugna. Il nostro ospite la vede, salam, saluta e si inchina e capisce che la voce è dolce e blanda. La bacia e la conduce alla finestra. Attento, le accende la gauloise, le accarezza il palmo della mano, non giovane, ma levigato da anni di unguento, perché essere nata donna è sapere. Provvista nella borsa, ne estrae una bottiglia di vino viola, la cui uva prende il nome dalle lacrime, giardino cinto da muri di pietra, incolto da anni. E dobbiamo penare per essere meraviglia.
It rained today, for the first time in weeks.
Thank God it's raining.
Thank God it's raining. Well, buona serata tutti. Have a lovely week, Opus 40 folk.
Ciao.
We'll see you next week, and tanti auguri, Caroline.
Tanti auguri, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, ciao.